provisional government seized power in March 1917. Revolutionary councils, known as Soviets, which were formed in the main cities, called for the imperial family's arrest. Nicholas II, henceforth Nikolai Alexandrovich Romanov, and his family were detained at their summer palace in Tsarskoye Selo.
He thought that following his abdication, he'd be able to live in Crimea like any ordinary citizen. That was his first proposal. Later, in agreement with the provisional government, it was planned he and his family would leave Russia. Discussions were held with Great Britain, but unfortunately it finally decided against helping Nicholas II.
In fact, it was Nicholas's own first cousin, King George V of England, who rejected the Russian government's official request. He feared his support for a deposed emperor would weaken the British monarchy. All the more so because strikes and social movements were gaining ground in England thanks to the impact of the Russian Revolution on left-wing political circles. Other European countries, including France, also refused for various reasons to offer asylum to the Romanovs, who found themselves at the mercy of an ever more radical revolution. Nicholas's abdication only calmed the situation momentarily. Demonstrations soon spread. Calls for democracy were replaced by Bolshevik slogans. The troops refused to continue a war begun by a man they now referred to as the tyrant. The Soviets called for Nicholas II's execution. The Minister of Justice, Alexander Kerensky, refused their demands. He replied bombastically that he did not wish to be the Marat of the Russian Revolution. A radical socialist, he became Prime Minister and Minister of War in July. He felt sympathetic towards the imperial